I saw him first in early days, I don't see him with Bob. I see him with Bunny. I saw him alone by himself.
Right now, I'm an Irie like Mr. Myrie, who generally sits on his veranda reading his diary.
I play on Peter Tosh's album for Coxon Studio One, you know. Overdub jumps. All those jumps that overdub on Bob Marley album for Studio One. That's me.
This devaluation, pound it a blow, it caused an eruption. Pound it a blow.
Peter Tosh is like a gospel singer, and I come from Westmoreland. And I'm coming to make a guitar. I got a post got, you know, the same kind of plastic string. That what him have with condensed pan, sardine pan turned back way. And then you put the thing over upon the sardine pan, like, and it when you play it, it make a sound. Like a banjo, you know, and it have a guitar sound. And it was well furnished and everything set up good, like he make it, his own guitar. He used to sing gospel in the park. He's not a man that beg people, him sing about him Jesus and everything and hallelujah and playing guitar and natural things and people come in the park and throw money in his hat and dress up nice. My one, you know, man, nice tall black youth when I see him in a hat and walking in guitar. I see him walk across the race course. It's called Hero Circle now. I saw like him of somebody that lived, like he walks from downtown to race course to go to crossroads after you. So I've seen him walking one day with a guitar, coming across and talk to him and tell him say, yeah, I'm a Jamaican, you know. Can come and shoot and help you, man. Tell him say, soon I'm gonna be a big star, man. You know? Come at home, mash it up. He was a self-taught musician and a lot of people didn't believe say a man could have taught himself to play music. Never go to a music school. And he was self-taught, and when he self-taught, he create music like West Montgomery couldn't read music, he just played. So, you know what I mean, people written what he played. So Peter Tosh make history, he make his own guitar and he create a guitar style for himself in reggae music that I see a lot of people use it after, with his wah-wah and thing. That little time that he was alive, make a big impact, and plus his words, like it hurt the establishment. And that's why he's not alive today. And I must make you know that, you know what I mean? Because his words, for every, like I tell the Bob Marley, we sing songs. And he sing songs for the world. But for Peter Tosh, he will say, you, come out of my land. Come out of my land. Stop teeth up my gold and my diamond. You know what I mean? He will tell you that. And he will tell you, say, apartheid. If you come out with apartheid.
In my land, dig out my diamond. I go fight against apartheid. We got to fight against apartheid.
He's the first man who sing about South Africa, apartheid. The brother was like scared of that subject. And he sing about apartheid in the reggae. And he, you know what I mean, reggae do a lot of things like in the early days, in the 70s, almost of those presidents in Africa, like Peter Tosh, Bonnevilleers, Bob Marley music generate those things, you know. And the early singers like the Burning Spear, you know what I mean? Generate the early singers then from them time to generate all this energy to these Africans.
Think you where you come from? As long as you're a black man, you're an African. No mind your nationality.
A lot of people come in now and say, oh, I was with Peter Tosh alive, and I know this and I know that. You know, like them say, oh, Peter Tosh give a man some gun. And a man, Peter Tosh don't love gun. There's a man who hate gun. If I come to the studio and him know some like a socialist drummer who like deal with gun, a bad man, him search me up. Ask me, you know, why you come to my place with no gun, you know. You deal with that, you know, fire button gun, you know. Peter Tosh, so don't, them who don't know Peter Tosh, we say, yeah, man, I've chew him talk, violence, and talk that. He's a man with a love gun. The man believe in him courage and be himself and can defend himself and Jack defend him. Don't tell a lie from a virgin about him gain a gun. Peter Tosh not deal with gun. Period.
They must get a baby. Yeah. The wicked have to get a baby. Yeah.
I wasn't happy to achieve when the man the police them getting a war, you know. I'm damaged seven of them, you know. I was there in Scotland up there. I think it was like 78, 79 around them time, man. Peter Tosh come out and smoke him ganja half a tree all the while, man. I'm like a pipe and smoke. So Peter Tosh was there smoking him ganja. And like, the police them pass Peter Tosh there all the while. And don't do nothing to him because they know him. The rest of that. You know, some police them abuse and discretion. And Peter that, so, man, they sing them great songs. So, they have them police there who like that. And they have some police who don't like Rasta. And that so happened that those police that passed this dumb little blue bag who don't like Rasta. So them say, hey, Rasta boy, you have permission to smoke the ganja. Eh? Rasta boy, you have permission to smoke the ganja. And Peter Tosh answer you if you call him Rasta boy. You know what I mean? Mom say, I? Who you speaking to? You must address I properly, you know. Don't call I a boy. You know what I mean? So policeman don't want to give Rasta nothing at all. Him come and Peter Tosh a dry him chalice and him man take it out of him hand. You can't take with the man chalice, but you touch him chalice like that. You hand touch it, him say a Babylon hand touch him thing. And like, whoa! One kick. Policeman drop down from ground and next man rush him. And him block him off and give him a next kick again. You know what I mean? He send them, you know. And then draw out him things, you know. So the first bunch have a retreat. It's the second bunch who come back now, where them come back now. And them worry man, step on them locks and all them things and beat him bad man. Him have to end up at the university hospital. You have to go look for him now. Boy and him left him just come there. And him friend scary. Sure, Mish Pad, Peter Tosh live. He know Peter Tosh when he live at Ensom. He come from prison now and claim says Peter Tosh make him go to prison and all them things. There. I see him out of halfway tree, you know. It's a jingle skill, you know. Before him go to kill Peter Tosh, he must do. When he come from prison, he spend some time. He come from Mongoose Town. But he never know which part Peter Tosh live. He offer him a brother named Scary. And Scary take him up there. Him brother know which part. Because Peter Tosh is a man who gives him bread enough things, give people things. So Peter Tosh is a kind man. You can't come in here and look at money and him give you money. So Scary used to come in my yard, which is Leper brother. So Scary carry Leper there. With both, maybe three of them are here. You know what I mean? Because Santa was there, you know. The drummer. Santa get out of the bed, you know. And his wife, which is named Marlin, Peter Tosh wife, get out of the bed too. That's all my life. But Doc Brown and Peter Tosh and Leroy, yeah, they were there standing up. Yeah, I was surprised, yes. I was looking for that. I was looking like for the Babylon, like maybe, yes, police, yes, take him life. But one of us, one black boy taking him life, especially him, Leper. You know what I mean? Because where Peter Tosh can do that much, make him want to keep Peter Tosh. What? You know what I mean? What you could have done that you can't talk to him about? I don't feel so, I think it's a grudge. Peter Tosh, you know Peter Tosh will end up on a smaller stage and get bigger. You come from prison and on a bigger stage. I'm living in a barbecue in a big house now and everything, man. You don't know if you approach him, deal him with your money. Because you have to know if you approach Peter Tosh, you know. Peter Tosh is a man, you not say he's unapproachable, but you have to know if you deal him. It's like, you know, you deal with a lion. And if you approach the lion, you have to just know how to deal with the lion.
I am the son of lightning, you cannot move by at all.
son of Jacob cannot be moved at all. I am the son of Moses, you can move I at all. I am the son of David, you cannot move at all.
I see myself as Peter Tosh a lot of times too, you know. You know what I mean? Like, act, be Rasta, hard to defend your right, you know what I mean? Don't know when you're in fear, you know what I mean? Because to us the greatest in is fear, and people like to get afraid. They either afraid of you or they want you to get scared of them and see the Rasta, you know what I mean? To me, it was the ultimate revolutionary, you know? Like myself, you know, because we don't really kill people, you know? People try to kill we, but we don't kill nobody. And we, you know what I mean? We might speak violent, but we are not violent. We speak the truth, and for that, you get persecuted for speaking the truth.
Everyone is crying out for peace, yes. None is crying out for justice. I don't want no peace. I need equal rights and justice.
I don't want no peace. I want equal rights and justice. He thinks about it. Peace is that thing you can sit on a table and you con me. I say, yes, we make peace. But you don't give me my equal rights and justice, I won't see the peace. So, I love Peter Tosh, man. Peter Tosh is, for me, Horsemouth. He's my idol. Trust me. He reminds me of myself. And I would love to be like Peter Tosh. That's the power.
A structure lined with iron from creation. King of the new generation, come to rule this nation. Watch it.